Melbourne Water proudly celebrates many years of growth by supporting an array of various activities that enhance life and livability at many local waterways, thanks to community participation in our River Health Incentives programs, part of which is represented by our yearly community grants. Community grants run annually and provide funding opportunities for groups and organisations to assist with on-ground works, administration and education.
Here at Badger Creek, also known as Corindert Creek in Hillsville, the Mount Toolabawong and District Landcare Group provides many great examples of what our community grants program can help to achieve. With local champions like Karen Garth and Maureen Bond leading the way, the group has rehabilitated the upper reaches of Badger Creek and then progressed downstream, complementing other waterways projects and ultimately the condition of the Yarra River.
So this part of the Wirrup-Yalik doesn't look very exciting. It's actually a very small part of the area providing drainage for Queen's Park, but it was the most wonderful thing a couple of years ago when we were doing a Melbourne Water Graceburn Festival. There was a platypus here scratching itself sitting up on the edge of this creek. How important even a tiny little tributary of one of the waterways draining this area can be for our wonderful platypus. So a number of the students that have helped us do the planting are from Hillsville Primary School, and every year for a day, every grade 3-4 student will come out to help us do at least 2,000 plants. So they also use the BMX track, and it just shows that we can, in a township area, combine some recreational and quite active use of a parkland area with relieving or allowing part of that to be left for the animals to enjoy by revegetating it and protecting that waterway.
The best part of my day planting trees was helping the environment grow with trees around it and stopping the rubbish going to the creek.
But 15 years ago, this site was quite degraded. We had very few mature eucalypts here in the area and no understory. Right behind me is a beautiful mature eucalyptus camphora or mountain swamp gum, which would have been all over this part of Hillsville in these swampy parts of the township. Since we've done our revegetation, we've now got the understory has come back, and also amazingly, we've got now the offspring of these eucalyptus camphora naturally regenerating within what we call our billabong area.
I'm standing here on the northern border of Toyota's manufacturing plant in Neltona North. Through here is a green oasis. We see the future as being to allow Mother Nature to take over the sites. With the assistance of Melbourne Water through their community grants, we can do things such as putting in these rabbit pute fences.
Since joining the group about 7 years ago, my natural interest has been the wildlife, which has been attractive because of all the plantings. When we first started, there was about 50 species of birds. Now we're up to 120 different species. And our aim is to take photos of as many of these species as we can. And this has been done in a list kept over the last 5 years of the species that we've seen.
Our major priorities when we started the Friends of Lower Coyd Creek were to green the creek corridor and to have a shared trail connecting the Bay Trail with the Coyd Creek Trail. With the assistance of our major partners, being Melbourne Water, Toyota and local councils, we've achieved the greening of the creek corridor and we've commenced work on the construction of the shared path. We're proud of our achievements to date and we think it'll be great in the future.
This site that I'm standing on is an old landfill site and has been built up and was planted last year. And you can see the she oaks and the golden wattle that are only 12 months, 14 months old, but contrasted with what's across the creek with this magnificent forest of green from 10 years ago.
Over the past 15 years, Friends of Lower Coleraine Creek, supported by community grants from Melbourne Water, in-kind assistance from Melbourne Water, and much more assistance from federal and state government, the Hobsons Bay City Council, and local industry, have transformed this section of creek by planting tens of thousands of Indigenous trees and bushes and ground covers, and turned it from a weedy, disregarded drain into a riparian forest. Over the years, Corroy Creek in this area has been absolutely transformed with the work of council, Melbourne Water and community groups. You know, tens of thousands of trees planted. But what's missing is the understory, as we call it, that used to be here, all the grasses, the native wildflowers. Before the primary school started their project here, this area was just mown grass with very limited habitat for native fauna.
The best part about being part of the community planning project in terms of adopting an area of Corroy Creek was this idea that the students feel this sense of that they do have some responsibilities not only inside their home but also outside of their community. So thinking a lot about what things could grow there to support the native animals as well.
In creating in planning our grounds for the future, we wanted to create a strong connection to place. So we wanted to create a strong link between our school and the work we're doing at the creek. And we really wanted to bring in that local, native and indigenous West flora and fauna for kids to learn in and play in and create like an outdoor classroom.
The Corroy Creek has inspired me in the future to come here and water plants and make sure the animals have got a safe home.
Efforts like this contribute to ongoing weed control, vegetation management, and the planting of over 3 million plants, all of which greatly contributes to protecting and improving the health of our waterways and the environment. Melbourne Water is proud of the projects achieved to date, and we look forward to collaborating with you on future healthy waterways projects.